Hare Krishna. Pleasure is too fragile a purpose to sustain us through life's troubles. We all seek pleasure. In fact, the pursuit of pleasure is what drives most of our activities. And yet, life can put us in such dilemmas, such traumas, that pleasure seems either utterly unavailable or utterly invaluable. So, for example, we may seek pleasure through watching movies, but if we lose a loved one, then what joy can we get in watching a movie? There are far more fundamental things in life that they matter far more than pleasure for us. So, if we make pleasure the purpose of our life, then our life can soon become purposeless, because we might lose pleasure completely at a particular point. And everything that is the source of pleasure might be deprived, stripped away from us. And then what will we do then? So we need a higher purpose. The futility of pleasure as a driving purpose of life sank into Arjun at the start of the Bhagavad Gita. In 2.8, he says, Nahi prapashyami mama panudyad yachokam choshanam indriyanam avapya bhumava saptanam ruddham rajyam suranam apichadhipatyam. He says, considering the grief of the loss of my venerable elders, the loss of my relatives, even the pleasure of an unrivaled kingdom on the earth or supremacy of the heavens, that will not remove the grief that is choking my very being. So, when we face calamities, at that time, if pleasure is the sole purpose of our life, we will be disoriented, devastated, crushed. However, we need a bigger purpose, a purpose that centers on taking responsibility and making a contribution. The Bhagavad Gita gives us such a purpose by explaining to us our own core indestructible spirituality, that we are souls, we are parts of God, and we are meant to play a role in cooperation with the whole. That by working in a mode of service and contribution in whatever situation we are in, we will be able to make a difference in the outer world, and most importantly, make a difference in our inner world. We'll be able to connect with Krishna and experience solace and strength and satisfaction in that connection. And by thus making a purpose, making the goal of serving and contributing in a mood of devotion to Krishna as the purpose of our life, we can take responsibility to use our talents properly, to do justice to the resources that we have been given, and to make a difference. So if this purpose is so deep that even if everything is lost from us, still the connection with Krishna will be there, because Krishna is always present within us, and we will always have consciousness by which we can become conscious of Krishna. And thus, this is a purpose, the purpose of connecting with Krishna and contributing to Krishna in a mood of service to Him, contributing for Krishna's service. That is something which we can always have. And that is a purpose which is so empowering and uplifting that it will sustain us through life's troubles. It was this purpose that Arjun understood and accepted by the end of the Bhagavad Gita, when he said, Karishye vachanam tava. That same Arjun who said that grief is choking my very being, he said that I have become pacified. Nashto mohasmati labdha tat prasadan mayachuta sitos migata sandeha. Karishye vachanam tava sitos migata sandeha. I become peaceful because, O Krishna, I am connected with you and I am dedicated to you. So rather than making pleasure as the purpose of our life, we can make service and contribution a purpose, and that will sustain us through life's inevitable troubles. Thank you. Hare Krishna.